Hi everybody, this is the third time I've tried recording this and making this video. I am so out of practice. I don't know how to use iMovie anymore. I've tried it twice on my laptop and it kept saying dropped frames and the recording stopped. So I'm having fits. So anyway, now I'm on my iPad, making sure I'm looking in the right spot. Anyway, I'm doing an update. It's been exactly 3 months since I've done a video. A lot of you have been asking about my health and how I'm doing and everything. Some people from Facebook know that I had stomach surgery. I need to have another surgery, and that's coming up December 6th. Since my last one, I did have the tumor removed from my stomach. They had to take 40% of my stomach, and then they reattached the small intestine. You know, your stomach has a valve at the end, and then your small intestine attaches to it there. Well, they cut the whole bottom half of my stomach off and, you know, sewed that up, and they reattached the small intestine somewhere along that line, I guess. I don't know exactly. As all I know is I only have 60% of a stomach now. He said it's kind of sort of like people who have gastric bypass, but not, you know. The surgery went okay. I was in the hospital 5 days, I guess 4 nights, 5 days. Everything went well. I was on a liquid diet the first 2 days, and then a soft diet, and then pretty much anything I wanted to eat as long as I didn't have any problems. And I didn't. I was eating okay. Pretty much anything I wanted. I had to change a little bit how I eat. I'm supposed to eat 6 small meals a day rather than 3 large. I'm finding that hard to do because, strangely, I'm eating just as much as I always did. I'm trying to cut back. I'm trying. Since that surgery, I lost like 10 pounds, but I've gained 2 of it back. So, anyway. The surgery went okay. Like I said, I was home a week and I started getting sick again. I got nauseous and I know TMI, but my stools were black and I knew I was bleeding internally. And one morning I got up real early to go to the bathroom and I almost passed out. So I woke up my husband and had him take me to the ER. We went to the ER downtown to the hospital where I had my surgery because, you know, that's where my doctors are. So, anyway, it was lucky. It was 6 o'clock in the morning on a Sunday and nobody was in there, so that was great. Anyway, they ended up admitting me, and the next day they called my gastroenterologist to do a scope to find the bleed and to repair it. So he came in, and that was Halloween day, October 31st, and he was wearing a Captain America t-shirt, and I thought that was so cute, and I told him, I said, oh, I love your shirt. And he said, yeah, my wife likes it too because she could be called Mrs. America. It's so funny. He's a great doctor. I love him. I found out later that he's a world-renowned gastroenterologist and that people come from all over to see him. So I felt fortunate that he was my doctor and I knew I was in good hands. So he found the bleed. They did the scope. Of course, they put me to sleep. That they found the bleed and he clamped it and everything was good. And so I was in the hospital another couple of days. I went home, I guess that Wednesday, and I've been doing good ever since. I had my follow-up with my surgeon and, you know, I'm done with him. I don't have to go back to him. Everything is good. I'm able to pretty much eat whatever I want. I've been really careful about different types of things. I'm still trying to stay on my heart healthy diet, which means I'm not eating red meats or fried foods or greasy foods and things like that. But pretty much anything I'm eating, you know, I'm trying to stay away from spicy foods though. And last night we ate Mexican to celebrate, and I'll tell you about that in a minute. But and I had a quesadilla, chicken and spinach quesadilla, and it was so good. And I'm going to have that for lunch when I finish this video, the leftovers. I was only able to eat about half of it. So I'm eating good. I'm taking vitamins, I'm taking all my other pills, and things are doing good. So I had to go see an oncologist yesterday because the gist that was in my stomach did have some dividing cells, which meant it was the beginning of cancer. But the surgery completely got it out. All the margins were clear and no lymph nodes were involved. So I'm virtually cancer-free. But with a gist, they have a chance of growing back. Mine, because of the size of it, but because the cancer cells were so few, I only had a 1.9% of it growing back. But still, they wanted me to see the oncologist to see if I needed to go on this pill, which is Gleevec, which they give a lot of leukemia patients are on that. So anyway, I was dreading that, thinking I might have to go on that pill because there are so many bad side effects to that. Not everybody can tolerate it. But anyway, he says that I don't need to go on it. I don't need to do anything else other than to monitor. Have regular scopes every 6 months for a year to make sure it's not growing back. And then yearly after that, and also a CT scan so they can better see everything. And so I am thrilled. So I don't have to worry about any nasty pill that's going to make me feel bad. And just monitor, so that's good. So a gist is a rare type of thing. It's different than a carcinoma cancer. It doesn't get into your circulatory system or in your blood or anything to where it plants seeds other places in your body. It doesn't metastasize or spread. So if it comes back, it comes back in the same place. So I guess if I had to have any kind of a cancer, that was an okay one to have, since it's not going to spread. And they got it all, so I feel good about that, and I feel kind of fortunate and lucky. So then the tumor in my lung, it's not in my lung, it's in the pleural lining around my lungs. It's quite large. It's about the size of a small potato, actually. There's two different ways that I had a biopsy and it was benign. But they really can't tell everything from a biopsy until they get it out of there and can really look at the whole thing, because it is, fairly large. So there's two ways they can take it out. They can do a large incision, kind of right here, and they would have to possibly take out a couple of ribs and remove it that way if it's attached to the chest wall. If it's attached to the lung by a thread or a stem, as he calls it, then he can just do like three small incisions and take it out that way. That's what we're hoping for, and that's what he thinks is likely for it to be. That surgery is less invasive. It's just three small little incisions, one for the camera, two for the instruments. They encapsulate it and pull it out, and they take a little triangle, little piece of the lung where it's attached, and that's it, and it's done. So, and the recovery from that is a lot quicker and easier. The other one, if I have to have the bigger incision and have to have ribs removed, they replace that with Gore-Tex or something. I don't know. That recovery takes longer and is more painful, sore. I don't know. I'm hoping that that isn't the case and that it's only attached to my lung by a thin thread, and they can get it out simply and just with the three small incisions. Again, this tumor is very rare, less than 800, it's like crazy. I'm getting these strange things. And again, feel fortunate that I had that heart attack and had the acid reflux, that I went and got that scope, that they found these things and had the x-ray and had the CT scan and they found these things. Otherwise, I could have had these for years and years, and they could have gotten so big that it would have been too late to do anything about them. So I feel lucky. So anyway, that surgery is on December 6th. I wanted to get everything done before the end of the year. And two, my insurance, my out-of-pocket money that I have to pay for medical is already paid. So anything I have done between now and the end of the year is free for me. So that was another incentive to go ahead and get this done. And the doctors were pretty confident that I'll feel well enough to go through this second surgery. So, and I'm looking forward to starting the new year with a clean slate. So hopefully next year will be much, much better, because this year has been holy hell with all my health issues. So on a good note, all my doctors now are downtown, which is almost an hour and a half away, depending on traffic. Sometimes we can make it in an hour and 10 minutes or hour and 15 minutes. Other times it's taken us 2 hours, depending on the traffic. But the doctors down there are so good. And, I live in a city where Houston is world-renowned for their medical facilities. And people come from all over the world to get help from, like, the cancer center and the different hospitals and doctors that we have here. Anyway, so I've been going down there. And the nice thing about that is that's where this great fountain pen store is. And so when I'm there for checkups or whatever, and it's the good time of the day to where we're not going to run into rush hour traffic, my husband takes me there. And yesterday I went and I got a new pen. Well, a few weeks ago I also went and I got a new pen. And did I get one or two? I think I got two. But I just brought one out to show you. This one is a Platinum 3776. This has a medium nib. I love this pen. I'm getting quite a collection of fountain pens. Isn't it beautiful? It writes perfect. I love this pen. And yesterday he told me that this was the best pen that they have in the whole store as far as price and how it writes and everything else. I just love this pen. But yesterday I went in and I wanted to look at the Visconti Van Gogh pens. And so I got one, and it came in this case. And I have it out of the case, but I'll show you the case that it came in. This is the painting by Van Gogh. It's called Pollard Willows. And this is the painting that the pen is fashioned after. And this is it. Oh my God, is it not beautiful? Look at all those colors. I love, love, love this pen. It is so beautiful. And it was on sale. Oh my God, I got it at such a good price. I could not walk away from it. So, Rock is going to be jealous when I tell her how much I paid. Anyway, this is the pen. This is the nib. I got a fine nib. Seems kind of thick to me, but it's a fine. So, and look at all the facets on the, can you see it? Oh, it's just beautiful. And it writes like a dream. And he filled it with some black ink for me. And it's just perfect. So they're my two newest acquisitions. Acquisitions. This is my little traveler's notebook that I have. I keep it on my desk here, and it has this little zip pouch. It has these little tablets in here, and I've been using it to just write down my thoughts, kind of like a journal. I've been writing, not every day, but just when I have something good to say, I'll write some things down, my thoughts. And I actually filled one book, and now I'm on the second one. I started in that one. So I love this little book. It's got a little leather cover. It's small enough I could put it in my purse. So yesterday I bought this other new one. This has a Rhodia tablet in it. And it's just a scribble pad, I guess. It has a nice little leather-like cover on it. I bought this little notebook. It's just, some great fountain pen friendly paper in it. and it has it's like a moleskin, mole skinne, as Rock says. Has a little pocket in the back. But mole skinne, some moleskin tablets or little notepads, are not fountain pen friendly. The ink bleeds on the paper and stuff like that. So these are much better for fountain pens. So I got this little notebook. And then I got another one. I just love pen and paper. So here's another little tablet just to keep in my purse and write little things down, like maybe a grocery list or something. So that, and I got this little pen case to carry my pen and protect it from scratches, to carry that in my purse with. They didn't have a green one or a brown one, which probably would have went better with my pen, but I got the purple because in the painting, if you will see, this area right here kind of looks purple. So I felt like this would go just fine. And I love it, I love it, I love it. I have also been knitting. I made one Christmas present for one son. I'm in the middle of making another one for another son. I can't show you because I don't think they watch my videos, but you just never know. And I'm also working on some socks. Let me show you that. I have several projects going at once. This is the yarn. I started this around Halloween, but then ended up back in the hospital and I haven't really worked on it much. So these were my Halloween socks, but actually they look like the Finding Nemo. They look like that clownfish, which I think is the name of the colorway for this yarn. Anyway, I'm doing on two circulars. I'm almost to the heel, so I have like this much more, and then I do the heel, and then start the second sock, and do the foot, and then I'll be on the second sock. The other thing I've been working on is my featherweight cardigan. I've been working on that forever, it seems, so I'll off and on. I don't work on it very much. I'm this far. This is the top, the neck part. And I've put my arm, sleeve stitches on a holder, and I'm doing the rest of the body part. And I do that for like 10 inches or so. And where is that thread coming from? Ooh, pulling. So this is that. It's a purple color. Isn't it pretty? Well, that's the wrong side. It's a beautiful yarn. I love the yarn. Let's see if I have the thing in here and I could tell you what it is. I bought this way back when we went on our trip. I bought this yarn and the pattern, actually, when we went on our trip up to East Coast a couple years ago. And finally getting around. It is Ultra Alpaca Fine. Which is 50% superwash wool, 30% nylon, and 20% alpaca, fine alpaca. Anyway, it's really, really soft. And so those are the main projects, the Christmas presents and these two other projects that I've been working on. And that's about it. We were gonna try to go see my son over in Charleston, the whole family actually, the week or so, week and a half before Christmas. But with my surgery and all, we're not going anywhere. So I'm at a get well, mode, taking it easy, resting up. I find that I don't have a whole lot of energy. I get tired really fast. So I'm trying to build my stamina some by, I keep moving and walk around and do as much as I can without overexerting, and trying to build my stamina, trying to eat good. So far I've been doing good. I'm shocked that losing that much of my stomach hasn't made more of a difference, or I'm not having more bad side effects from that. At least so far, I'm being careful. So that catches you up on me and what I've been doing, and it's not much else. Thanksgiving is next week, and my son's birthday, and then we have my grandson's birthday, and then Christmas already. So I've got to get my Christmas shopping done. I want to get it done before my surgery. So maybe the week right after Thanksgiving, I'll have to quickly do that. I don't know. I'll have to fit it in. Maybe this weekend. So thanks everybody for watching and for sending me thoughts and prayers on Facebook and even on YouTube. And keep me in your thoughts and prayers for my next surgery, and hope that it's just the less invasive one, because it's a difference of 2 to 3 days in the hospital, or 4 or 5. And a lot more pain involved if they have to do the big surgery. So, pray for those little ones. So maybe I'll be lucky with that too, and I'll be good to go. So one thing I do want to say is, you know, listen to your body. You know when you're not feeling well. And, you know, I even told the doctor, the oncologist yesterday, that a few years ago, I was even looking up on the internet, stomach cancer. And he said, why? And I said, well, because every time I would eat, my very first bite, it would hurt right here on my chest. And it would hurt. It was uncomfortable. And, you know, so I was looking up stomach cancer and what are the symptoms and stuff, and decided, you know, well, that wasn't it. And which led me to the acid reflux and getting on medication for that. And once I started that medication, the pantoprazole, that feeling went away, and I was able to eat without any pain or anything. So I thought, oh, it was just that acid reflux and that indigestion and stuff. But I never did go get the scope until after I had the heart attack, and my cardiologist said, you should have that scope done. Because you've had that for quite a while, and that acid stuff can lead to all kinds of things. So I listened. First time in my life I did something right. I listened. And I did go and get that scope. And that's, I feel fortunate that everything was discovered then, before it got too big and was too late. So, because I told them I plan on living till I'm at least 100. So, anyway. Well, that's it. I hope you all have a great, great Thanksgiving, that you're sharing it with loved ones, and you don't get eat too much turkey and get too sleepy and all of that. So, okay, everybody, thanks, and I'll talk to you again soon, hopefully. Bye.